Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Our distinguished guest, Professor Dr. Mohsin Shaikh from India, and all of the students, we are very thankful that we have an expert in human resource management come from India. Yes, this time is an coincidence. In coincidence that the professor Dr. Mohsin come to Jogja for a conference. However, because we have contact before, then he have time for us, for the students, to give his speech about human resource and with a very interesting topic. So thank you very much, Prof. Mohsin, for your coming. And this is our campus and our lovely students, and they are smart as well, hopefully. Yeah, so I hope that later after the lecture, guest lecture from Prof. Mohsin, we have some discussion, and for the students, please give some response and question, so we have discussion. Yeah.
Most important topic today, talking about human capital and talent management. I think it is a very interesting topic for us, how to maintain and to develop people to gain a competitive advantage in the organizations. For making the time more effectively, maybe for making time more effectively, maybe it's good for us to let Prof. Mohsin Shaikh to present about the talent management and human capital. Okay, let's.
So, everyone in the organization wants good people and wants to retain good people. Now, how can an organization get good people, and how can an organization maintain good people? So this is what talent management is all about. The first thing you should understand is that what is talent? How do you define talent? Everyone says that we want talented employees. Or your university will also say that we want talented students. Everyone is talking about talent. Now the question is, what is talent? How do you define talent? Now this concept of talent management was given by this author, Elizabeth Chambers and others. They were from the world's number one consultancy organization, McKinsey. So they were working on this project, and they wrote one paper in the McKinsey journal, McKinsey Quarterly. And for the first time in 1960s, they came up, 1998, they came up with this concept of talent management in their paper on war for talent. And after that, the term talent management became popular. So this is how the word talent came into existence or became very popular. Now, how do you define talent? Now, talent is nothing but the ability, aptitude, bent, capacity, endowment, faculty, flair, forte, or genius. This is what we mean by talent. That is ability, aptitude. Yes, some have different abilities, different aptitudes, different capacities, different endowment, different faculty, different flair. And some are very genius. We call he is a genius person. That means he is a talented person. So this is what we mean by the term talent. Now, another definition of talent could be unusual ability to do something well that can be developed by training. So, if you are good at doing something, or if you are very good at doing something, and this can be developed by training, then that can also be called as a talent. A people or person with an exceptional ability. Some people have exceptional coding ability. Some people have exceptional programming ability. Some people have exceptional numerical ability. So this is their talent. So this is what means by talent. Our talent consists of those individuals who can make a difference to organizational performance either through their immediate contribution or in the longer term by demonstrating the highest level of potential. Now, these are the general definition, the first, second generation, third definition, these are general definition of what talent is. Now, in the organizational context, talent means, it consists of those individuals. Now, talented employees are those employees which can make a difference to the organization performance. So these employees, we call them as talented employees. Either they can contribute today or they have the potential to contribute in the future. So these type of employees are called as talented employees. Now, when we say we understand what is talent, the definition of talent, the next important aspect is talent management. Now, what is talent management? Talent management is a process. Talent management is a process. So it is a set of business practices or the skills of attracting highly skilled talent, integrating new talents, and developing and retaining current talents to meet the current and future business objectives. So talent management consists of different business practices which the organization follows in order to attract good people, in order to develop good people, and in order to maintain or in order to retain good people or talented employees. So this is a set of business practices. So it is also the planning, possession, development, retention, and growth of talent who are of particular value to an organization. That could be because of their leadership capabilities or perspective for future, or even because they are satisfying business critical roles and which could actually lead to organizational sustainability, efficiency, and excellence in order to achieve business goals. So not everyone in the organization is a talented employee. Those organizations which play a critical role, those organizations which are employed on critical roles, that means these roles are very much necessary for the business performance or for the results of the organization. The planning and managing of these employees who are in the critical positions in the organization, this is what we mean by talent management. Now, how do you go about managing talents? The first important aspect is the clear understanding of organization's current and future business strategies. If you want to have a good talent management system in the organization, we should understand what are the current and what will be the future strategies or business strategies of the organization. Second important aspect is, here we should be able to identify the gap between talent in place and talent that is required. So we should identify the gap. What is the current talent which we have and what will be the talent that we require in future? If there is any gap, we have to identify this gap and try to fill this gap. A sound talent management plan designed to close the talent gaps. and it should be integrated with your strategic business plan. So identify what is the gap and how are you going to fill that particular gap, and accurate hiring and promoting decisions. So we should be able to attract new talents, and we should be able to promote people who have talent to the higher positions. So these are some of the important aspects. Then there has to be a connection between the individual goals and the goals of the organization, because integration of organizational goals with the individual goals is very important. Here, the organization has to contribute so that he is able to achieve the organizational goals. Development of talent to enhance performance in current position, as well as readiness for transition to the next level. So this is another very important aspect. We are preparing in talent management, the focus is on preparing students, or the focus is on preparing the employees for higher positions that will occur in the future. Another important is the focus is not only on the strategy or talent strategy, but how are you going to implement that? Preparing a strategy is important, but more important is how are you going to implement that strategy? So that is also important. And what will be the impact of this on the effectiveness, efficiency, and productivity of the organization? So while designing any performance, while designing any talent management strategy, we should keep all these things in mind. So this is a model of talent management system, and these are some of the components of the talent management system. Here we have talent management, then talent engagement, then alignment of the business goals with the HR goals, then integration with the systems and technology, and your HR strategy. And these are the different HR aspects, like onboarding, training, development, performance, appraisal, compensation, reward. So this is the structure or a framework of any talent management system or talent management process in an organization. Now, why there is a need for talent management? Why more and more organizations are focusing on talent management? Why it is required? Now, why people are doing this? Why organization is doing this? Because it has been found that there is a significant relation between talent management and business performance. If you have good people, good talent management system, your business results will be good. So the better the talent management system, better would be your business results. Now, it is only the talent which is a source of competitive advantage, because everyone has the same technology, everyone has access to technology, everyone has access to finance, everyone has money. But what differentiates one organization from another is their talent or their people. Another important aspect is that the context or the environment in which business is being performed is becoming very dynamic, very complex. So in such a complex and dynamic environment, we require good people. So talent management is required because the business is becoming more and more dynamic and complex. Boards and financial markets are expecting more. That means the owners, the board of directors, and the financial markets, they expect more from the organization. They are expecting more performance, more profit, more return on investment. And therefore, we should have a talent management system. Employee expectations are also changing. So employees also want more and more salary, more and more growth and development opportunities. So if we have a sound talent management system, we can address the aspiration and expectations of the people. And workforce demographics are evolving. So more and more youngsters are joining the workforce. So we have different categories of people, Generation X, Generation Y, Generation Z, or we call them as millennials. More and more youngsters, millennials, are joining the organization, and managing such type of people is very challenging. If we have a talent management system, it is easy to manage such type of people. Now, how do we have a good talent management system? What are the best practices in managing talent in the organization? The first is that the talent management strategy should be integrated with your business strategy. So there has to be a link between your talent management strategy and your business strategy. So what is your business outcome? What do you want to achieve? What is your business strategy? According to your business strategy, you should formulate your talent management strategy. Now, talent management professional needs to move from seat at the table to setting the table. Now, that means here, talent management people should not be backbenchers. They should discuss, they should come in front, and they should have a say in decision making. That means they should be able to convince the top management regarding the utility and importance of talent management system. The talent pipeline is only as strong as its weakest link. Now, talent management should not only be confined to one particular department. It should not be confined only to senior position, but we should have talent management system for all levels of the employees. Not only for the low level employees, but also for senior, middle level executives, senior level executive and top level executives. Everywhere we require good people. And talent management is not a democracy. Now we know that in democracy everyone is treated equal. That is the concept of democracy. In talent management, you cannot apply this principle of democracy that everyone will get the same salary, everyone will get same type of promotion, everyone will get the same incentive. No. If you want to promote talent, if you know that this is a talented employee, and if you want the talented employee to stay in the organization, we have to offer him, maybe for others you are offering one incentive, we can offer him three incentives. Why? Because he's a very critical and talented employee. We want to retain that employee. Therefore, we have to give him special treatment. So that is what do you mean by talent management is not democracy. There has to be some discrimination, positive discrimination. That means if you want to retain good people, talented employees, we can go out of our way and give them more rewards, more benefits, more training. Then potential performance and readiness are not the same. Now we should understand that there is a difference between the current performance, potential performance and readiness. So current performers are the people who are performing well, whose performance is well today. Potential performance are the people, that means over a period of time, their performance will increase. They will give high performance over a period of time. And there are certain people who will be ready in the next future. Immediate future, they will be ready with good performance. So we should identify who are the current performers, who are ready for performance at a short time, and who has the potential for performing better in the future. Accordingly, we have to manage these people. And software is not equal to talent management. Now, another important aspect is, when we talk about talent management, everyone thinks that having a ERP system, having a human resource information system is talent management. No, that is only a technology. That is only a software. Software is not talent management. Talent management is more than that. So software, ERP system, human resource information system, these are just tools for talent management. That is not talent management. If you implement human resource information system, that does not mean that you have implemented talent management system. It is just a tool for implementing talent management system in the organization. So this is all about what is talent, definitions of talent, and why talent management is important. and what are the best practices of managing or implementing a talent management system in the organization. So this was all about human capital and talent management. So talent management again is a part of your human capital management in the organization. So this is how talent management is important for any organizations. So today we discussed about the concept of human capital at national level, at the organizational level, at the individual level, importance of human capital, the link between human capital and economic development. Then we discussed about talent, what is the definition of talent, what do you mean by talent management system, why talent management system is important, and what are the best practices in implementing a talent management system in an organization. So this is what I wanted to discuss. Once again, I would like to thank the head of your department, Professor Dr. Retno, and your faculty members, and all of you for sitting here for the 2 years with patience. Thank you very much.